Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome to today's video. So a lot of people have been asking me to do a second review on the Lorex 4K NVR camera system. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna do a update review for you guys. Some guys asked if I could do a bit of a install video, and I'm still honestly only halfway through the install. Just life's got in the way and I haven't installed all the cameras, but I have half them up. So I'll show you the install. Let you guys know kind of where we're at. I think it's been about 3 months since I installed it. So let's go ahead. I'll show you guys the cameras. I'll show you guys how I ran it and how I will plan to continue running them. And I'll update you guys again with a few more videos on this system on how I do the complete setup. But let's get into it. All right, so if you guys remember last time, I just kind of just temporarily installed the camera or just laid the camera there and we had it hooked up to the TV outside. So if you look here, this is where I installed my cameras, and you guys can use whatever tactics, I guess, or methods that you would prefer. One of the reasons why I went with this, so you could, a lot of people tend to put their camera at the front door facing out, which is all good and whatnot, but at the same time, if there's gonna be any point of entry through your windows or your doors or anything like that, you're not gonna really see it. So for example, if I had to put my camera at the top of the door, somewhere in this area facing outwards, you're not gonna see any intrusion on the windows and whatnot. So I felt like this was a better idea, was to put it this way, and I'll show you guys the view on those cameras in just a second, but this way you can see the whole front of the house. If somebody's, you know, trying to do something at the front door or something, you can see it. Anybody leaves a package there, you can see it. It gets all the detection you need. So this is covering that way, and then the other camera, of course, is facing out towards the street. One of the reasons why I did these two so close together, it makes the wiring job a lot easier. When you do it this way, you only have to drill one hole, and you're only going to one spot with two cables, so you can drag two of the cables that are supplied. And as you can see there, I just drilled through there, and I ran them all in the ceiling, which I found was the simplest way to get this done. So that's just kind of how I ran it. I came through, and I'll show you guys in the rafters in just a second, but came through, used a staple gun, stapled everything in place, put all my connections underneath any of these, you know, fascia or roof overhang. That way there's no rain that can, you know, mess with anything. And there you go. So I have two here, and let me show you the other two. I've only got four installed right now. So here's the other two that I installed, and same sort of principle as before. This one is getting this half of the driveway. It might seem a little bit redundant putting two at the front of the house, but they both are serving their purposes because I do have a fairly wide driveway. So I have one here, one on the other side, and then this one is facing the backyard. And this kind of goes against the, or with the same sort of ideas what I was doing with the last one. This covers actually most of the backyard. And I was thinking about putting one, you know, there's this door here, this side door entry, so it covers that if anybody's gonna try and do an intrusion there. And I was thinking about putting one on the back side of the house facing this way, but honestly, the view that you get out of this one camera here pretty much covers the whole side of this house. So I'll let you guys know what the other plan is for the rest of the cameras, but I'll go back inside and I'll show you guys the rest of the setup and how these run through. So same thing, they run through, I drill the hole, and they go inside. I'll show you guys where they lead to. All right, so we're inside the garage, and this is what I mean as far as how they run. So they come out right there in the corner. I'm still gonna bundle them up, and because they're kind of wound in the tight rolls that they come with in the kit for the cameras, I ran them all the way down. As you can see there, there's the white wires, and up into my attic. So they go in there, and then same thing on this side. They come through over there, right there. They run all the way across right there. And same thing, I drilled a hole into the attic. And now I'll get into where and why I put the actual NVR where I did. Okay guys, so this is not gonna be the most pretty sight, but this is the attic. So it's definitely not supposed to be super fancy up here, but what I did was, I'll show you guys, I ran my NVR to a central location. A little bit controversial, and I'll kind of talk about a few things. I do want to make a little shelf here so that it's not resting close to the actual heater, but the reason why I put it here is it's central. This is in the center of the house. There's a power source here. You can plug it in
and you can run all your wires centrally to here. And the reason why I put it up here is this alleviates having to run the wires back down through the wall, back down into your home, and having a bunch of spaghetti downstairs. Whereas you can just run it up here, plug it all in, and you have a power source here, and it all just kind of makes sense. Plus, if there was ever any intrusion in your home, if you have it up here, nobody's ever gonna find it or, you know, go through the work to try to find this or try to get it, because this has everything on it. So that's why I put it up here. I also installed a battery backup here. So this is actually, I have my battery backup plugged into here, and then I have the, it's not Ring, that's just a box I put here, but I have the Lorix system sitting here, just to kind of lift it off of, you know, the furnace or whatnot, but it's supplied on this. So what happens is, with the battery backup running this, if I have a power failure, all of my cameras are still running. So that's another added bonus. I'll link that down in the description if you guys want to check out the one that I got, and also I'll link this camera system. So this is kind of where it's at, and you just kind of run the cables obviously to wherever you got to go. So I got those ones running over there, and the other ones run across over there. And I want to put some cameras at the back of the house, which with having this here, it's pretty easy, right? You grab the cable, plug it in, and you go over to where you got to go, pop it out to wherever you got. I could put it on that side of the house, really wherever. So like I said, not the prettiest up here, but this is the most functional and the easiest solution on how to run this.
All right, so now I'm gonna show you guys the app on the actual phone. So this is what it would look like on your phone, and it kind of loads like this, and I'll show you guys what it looks like through here. So this is the resolution on the phone. So it might not be top quality, but this would be the view that you would get through the phone. And this is a side gate here. So like I said, you can pretty much see all the way to the backyard, see the gate, see the side door, everything we need to see over here. So, and then this is the front of the house. So you can see the street clear. Again, this is the resolution on the phone and my screen recording on the phone, but just even pinching and zooming like this, you can clearly see anything on the street. And I have this side in view of the driveway and any vehicle that I park on this side of the driveway, so it helps there. And then here's this one gonna load. So this is the other side of the driveway. As you can see, you can clearly see all these vehicles and everything there. I know it's pretty dirty, but you can see, you know, very clear if there's anything coming down the street, or if you have to zoom into a license plate, it's very clear and serves for that purposes on that side. So here's the front house. So this is with loading here. You can pinch in. Like I said, you can see the front windows, see the front door, any intrusion that may happen there, any people coming to your door or packages that they're leaving. You can see them walking away from the door. So that's why I went with that view, and it works well. Okay, so next up, this is the night vision, and this is the side gate here. One of the things is that side light right there does kind of mess with the night vision a little bit, but you can see, I definitely can see what's going on the side of the house, but maybe without the light on, may or may not be better. I'll leave that up to you guys. Here is the front of the house, and this is really clear, guys, for night vision. It is very dark compared to what this is showing. So this is brightening up the picture quite a bit. It's seriously pretty dark outside. You can see, you know, right to the street, and this is supposed to be color night vision, so does look like it's achieving that. But here's the other side of the house. Again, color night vision. You can see the grass is green, and you can zoom in and see, like I said, this is pitch black outside, and this is the kind of light and brightness that comes from the picture. So pretty decent, honestly. Here's the front of the house, and it's super dark in the front of the house too. I only have that one light under that porch there, and you could easily see anybody, you know, coming from the door. If somebody decided to go to the door and turn around and come back, you would see that for sure.
All right, guys, so that's gonna pretty much do it for today's video. I do have some other videos planned for you guys on this. I wanna show you guys exactly, I'll probably do it with just one camera or cable run. I'll show you guys right from hooking it up to the NVR all the way to the camera, drill in the hole, and also when you do drill the hole and you run this, I usually end up cutting the connector off and crimping a new one on. So I wanna make those videos for you guys, showing you guys how to crimp the connector on. And I'm just finishing up some home reno on the back here, so it's kinda why I didn't run the cameras on the back, just redoing the backyard, and I'm gonna be putting the cameras up here facing the multiple directions. So that's all to come. If you guys have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. Honestly, I haven't played with like the face recognition and stuff like that. If I'm being 100% honest, I did turn off the notifications on my phone.
because I found that it was just hammering my phone with notifications. There may be an update. I do have to check. Like I said, life's gotten away a little bit. And I've just kind of taken a little bit of a break from it. It's just, it's recording. There's no issues. I have a Ring installation of the security system. So I kind of rely on that if anything goes wrong. And then I would look at the cameras or anything like that. So I just leave the cameras recording 24/7. But I'll continue to break this down for you guys. And then once I get all 8 cameras, I'll let you guys know how much record time you actually have. Right now, it seems like with 4 cameras running 24/7, I only get about 2 days of recording. So take that for what it's worth. That's kind of ballpark where I'm at. So with the standard hard drive that's in it, I'm only getting about 2 days of recording time on 4 cameras continuous. So if I hook up the other or 4, so they have a total of 8 cameras, I'm probably going to only have 1 day of recording. So I know you can put a bigger hard drive in, but we'll cover all that later. Any questions? You guys want me to do anything else in the system? Let me know down below, and I will see you guys on the next video. Make sure you give this one a thumbs up, subscribe, and see you guys in the next video.